Hey, welcome back to another deep dive with Colin. Today we're going to talk about tonal prints. Tonal prints are typically achieved when you print a clear ink on top of, you know, onto your fabric, and you get a disruption of the fabric, a little darkening of the fabric. What I want to touch on is why that happens and how you can manipulate the ink and choose shirts to enhance that effect in order to get a really nice tonal print. And what I have here today in front of me are a few examples that I just printed, basic level of what you're going to look for and expect, and then we're going to talk about some of the things I've encountered in my print career. So, tonal prints, how do they happen? What happens? What's that interaction? So any clear ink printed onto polyester fabric is going to have a chemical interaction that darkens up that shirt color. The easiest way to talk about it is it looks wet. It's not actually wet, but it looks wet. So it's a darkening of that polyester thread. If you do this on cotton, you don't see anything. As an example of that, all these prints that I have here in front of me, this is the same ink here. So in this area, you don't see any color shift, even though this is a tri-blend white fabric. The white polyester doesn't darken up at all because it's white. But if we put that onto a color fabric, then we get quite a lot of variance. Now, we talked about it, the ink reacting with that polyester thread and darkening up. Depending on that polyester thread itself, if you get 10 t-shirt brands, you go between a 50-50, a tri-blend, 100% cotton, or sorry, 100% poly, you are going to see slightly different reactions across all the different polyester threads, depending on where they were manufactured, what they were manufactured with, any kind of chemical coating, you're going to get slightly different variants. And we're going to show you that here. So we showed the white, how it had no color change. Now this is a 50% recycled cotton and 50% recycled polyester. And we have a slight darkening of the garment compared to the outside. You get really good examples of that here on the edges and here in this little drop shadow. But here, I have two prints because I used four different total clears. We have, in fact, I have a piece of tape marking which one this one. This was Curable Reducer and this was Fashion Soft from Wilflex. And then these are just two different clear bases, an extender base and a halftone base. Very similar reactions. But this is the same ink being printed down. So between all of these, you have very different reactions to the clear going down on that garment. So if you get a full color range from, you know, super light to super dark and you print the same clear ink on all of them, you're going to see different strength coming out of that. So you'll get everything from a nice subtle, you know, red here to a very dark looking gray on top of this shade of gray. And that's what I wanted to showcase for you, that all of this tonal reaction is 100% reacting to the clear ink on a polyester thread. So play with that and experiment. So between these and then 100% poly garment, you can see that the polyester garment here, 100% poly, is reacting much lighter in comparison to the tri-blends and the 50-50s that we just showed you. So this is a Curable Reducer and this is Fashion Soft. Between these two inks, this polyester fabric is reacting differently, even though down here, that's the same. This is the Curable Reducer and the Fashion Soft. Here, there is a small tonal difference. I'm not sure if it'll pick up on camera, but it's there. But on this fabric, it's easier to see that. And then here, we have the two clears. And again, there is a slight difference, but it's harder to see in comparison to some of the others. So that's the foundation of what I wanted to talk about, how clear itself is going to react with polyester thread. Now, I had a print that I was doing at the last shop I was working at. It was a tonal background, and we tested on very similar fabrics to what we were going to run in production. We just didn't happen to have that one. And our experience said, oh, it's going to be very similar. There's going to be very minor change. So if we print this sample with this clear in the background and send it to our customer for approval, we'll get the same result. When we got in that the garments for that run, this was it was somewhere between 5,000 and 10,000 pieces. It was a lot. And we printed that first sample to get an approval. That garment reacted quite strongly. In fact, there was a 2 to 3 times darker than what we intended. And we were like, how did this happen? Well, the clear we were using just obviously impacted and worked with that polyester thread far more than what we were expecting. So we scrambled to find another clear that was gonna do what we needed. We ended up finding a curable reducer that gave us the look we were going for. It wasn't the same, it was still a little darker because that polyester thread reacted so strongly, but we had to find something that did not interact and darken that fabric up. So play with it, experiment, have fun. This is awesome. All right, so that's the foundation. Clear ink interacts with polyester thread to darken up the color of that polyester thread. So what happens if we want to add a little bit of color or a little bit of black to that clear ink to then darken up the color? So this much deeper, much richer red than with just a clear ink. Let me pull this over here. Get this down into shot a little better. We can see that this is quite a bit different. There's quite a bit more richness in the ink that I darkened up with a little bit of black. All I did was add 0.5% of black to the clear. So that was 99.5% clear and 0.5% black. Specifically, these were Wilflex products. I used the diamond black and their halftone base for this, but just that tiny addition of black, 0.5%, gave us a much darker response to the shirt color. And you can see that here, where we did that print before on white, and there was no color there. This is that 0.5% of black on a white t-shirt. It looks like a very light gray. Now, I'm not saying go and do this for your grays, but this is what it looks like if you were to print this on a white. This very light gray ends up darkening up quite a bit when you end up printing on polyester. Is that on the red t-shirt that we had pulled out at the beginning, just the clears, so we can get you a good side-by-side of what the difference is. 0.5% of black into clear, and you get this shift in the color development, the tonal development. So that's what I wanted to relay today in the deep dive. Play, have fun, create these awesome tonal prints. They're going to do a lot for you in what you can offer your customer if they're looking for a simple print across a lot of different colors. Tonal has always been a fantastic choice for that. And this is how you achieve that. As a bonus, some people will be asking about, well, what about doing white? Can I do that with white to lighten out the garment a little bit? You can, but it becomes a little bit more tricky. Doing little bits of white doesn't quite give you the look that you really want, but it does give you the opportunity to create an awesome looking vintage print. So this white is a mix 50-50 of Fashion Soft and Bolt White. And I printed this through a 230 mesh with a hard squeegee, a 70-90-70 squeegee, a good hard flood, good hard pressure on a single print stroke. And what that does when it hits the fabric is it seeps into the shirt just a little bit, and any texture on the shirt, any balls of lint or little balls of the yarn, of the thread itself kind of balling up, stuff you'll see if you look at it under a microscope, it tends to saturate that and cover it up really good, but it's a crazy thin print. If you were then to use a smoothing screen or a heat press stampinator, hot iron of any kind on press, you get a really butter smooth print. And that vintage look and vintage feel you get out of that print is amazing. I used to have dozens of shirts like this that I would wear all the time, last through the wash really well. This is not ever meant to be a heavier, durable, never split when you pull on the shirt type of print. This is meant to be something that's a little bit more like water-based in that it goes around the fibers. It doesn't necessarily bridge those fibers. So do not expect that. We're talking about getting a really clean, soft print. And from a foundational point of view, that's how easy it is to do a tonal print. Clear ink on polyester will darken it up. Darken your ink just a little bit to darken that fabric a little further. Since this is not meant to be a heavy, durable print, you can go ahead and use higher mesh counts and get a thinner deposit of ink on there for a near water-based like feel. If you're doing light inks on darks, higher level of product like Fashion Soft, a super soft hand additive to really reduce down that ink. High mesh printing, hard squeegee printing will give you really nice, fashionably soft feel vintage prints. Thanks for joining us in another deep dive on how to create tonal prints. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. If you have any further questions on things that we might talk about, leave a question below. We'd love to talk to you. See you guys next time.